many people, they should not look at you. These days in London, there are women who are suffering from a funny disease called anorexia, where they just don't eat. Women just don't eat because they should be thin and skinny. For what? For what you should be thin and skinny? Because you look attractive. But for what? I don't think skinny people look attractive by any chance. Horrible. They create only pity in you. And you feel, you know, repulsive about the whole stuff. Once a beauty queen came to see me, I thought she was a TB patient. And I said, well, you look all right, but it seems you are a TB patient. She said, no, mother, I've got a beauty prize. I said, who were the people? Doctors must have given you, because they want some patients there. This is the trouble. We go out of the way to trouble our nadi, not to eat your food, fasting. If you want to fast this life, next life, you will not have any food. Thank you very much. No food. Fasting, all right. You will have a permanent fasting. What do you say? You don't have to do any fasting. Why do you want to fast? And even if you want to fast, because you want to change the timing, or maybe for your health's sake, it's all right. But why in the name of God you want to malign him? You have got everything to eat and you don't want to eat. Those who have got food to eat, they don't want to eat. Next life they become poor. And then they blame the rich. But in last life you wanted to fast. So this life you are not given any food because you asked for it. And that is how also the Nabhi Chakra gets you twisted when you fast like mad. There is no need to fast in the name of God. God has given you all the wealth, all the beauty, all the love. Actually, in Sahaja Yoga, if you fast in my name, I think it's horrible. Because if you want to trouble your mother or to make her uneasy or take a revenge on her, then you say, mother, I'm not going to eat my food. Then mother is finished. That's the best way to conquer her. To say, mother, I'm not going to eat my food. So this kind of mad fasting is also very bad for your nadi. And when you do that, then you have a problem because you are invaded by your left-sided, what you call the beyond the Ida Nadi, you have the collective subconscious. And you are invaded by them. And you are in for trouble. Physically, mentally, emotionally. And mostly those people who fast are very hot-tempered. The day their fasting day is there, never go near them. Because they are already planning what they are going to eat. And in the morning they plan, and they don't get it. So they are very angry for that one. All these asahaja things are not going to happen. You have to be normal people. You don't have to put up into tension yourself for Sahaja Yoga, nothing. Be normal. Be nice people. Don't torture yourself. That is one point on the nabhi on the left hand side, and on the right hand side, don't get into indulgences. Don't pamper yourself. Both things are the same for Sahaja Yoga, whether you starve or you overeat. It's the same. There is no difference between the two. Because if you are not on the seat, whether you are on the left falling or the right, does it make any difference? So to be on the seat is to be in the blessings of Sri Lakshmi. And I have described to you how Sri Lakshmi is a lady. And in her left hand, she has got two lotuses and the right, one lotus and right hand another lotus on top. It shows a person who is balancing. She's balancing on a lotus. Imagine, she's standing on a lotus. That means she's balancing. And she's balancing, she's standing there. And she is holding two lotuses in her hand. showing that she's like a lotus.